PSA is a protein made by cells in the prostate, the same cells that can turn into prostate cancer, that is normally present in men without any prostate disease at very low levels in the bloodstream. When the prostate is affected with a disease, so non-cancerous prostate enlargement, infection, prostatitis, inflammation, or prostate cancer, more PSA leaks into the bloodstream and it can be detected with a laboratory test. We know that some men with very low PSAs have prostate cancer, but in general, the higher the PSA, the more likely that someone has prostate cancer. And the only way to know for sure is to have a prostate biopsy, which is passage of a needle through the rectum into the prostate, usually 12 to 14 times in one setting. And that gives the pathologist material to look at under the microscope and can determine if an increase in PSA level is due to prostate cancer or some other condition.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed, but right now a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment, or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.